Okay, let's get back to it. You can play for about another 3 hours.
Good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel. Top priority clearance.
Is it the Ambassador?
It's not his signature. I think it's from the Council. I'll patch it through to the comm room.
Commander Shepard. We've received information that may be critical to your mission against Saren.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
You mean spies?
Spectres tend to attract attention, Commander. But they are only one arm of the Council. Special task groups are often a better option for monitoring developing situations.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, we thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Vermeer.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Vermeer. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything
else. Yeah, I'm not going to Vermeer for a long time, so... you'll just have to chill on that for a bit.
Urgent message from Alliance Command coming in. I'll patch it through.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett from Alliance Command. We've got a situation here, and you're the only one that can handle it.
What do you need, Admiral?
There's an Alliance training ground where we test weapons and technology in live fire simulations. One of the VIs we use to simulate enemy tactics in the drills is no longer responding to our override commands. It's gone rogue.
Are you telling me this computer is thinking on its own?
We're not stupid, Shepard. This is a virtual intelligence, not a true AI.
Right,
It's not self-aware, and it can't access any external systems.
Yeah, sure.
We didn't do anything illegal here. Virtual intelligence support is critical to our military success. VIs process thousands of status reports and react in nanoseconds. No human can do that. We need you to fight your way through the training ground of the VI Corps and manually disable it.
Don't worry, Admiral. I'll take that thing out.
I know Spectres answer the Council, but you're still human. You're still part of the Alliance military, and right now we need you. The VI controls all the facilities, weapons, drones, and automated defenses. You're the only one that can pull this off, Shepard. Good luck.
That'll be the next thing I do, because doing that quest unlocks my subclass. Very useful. I'm going to start bringing Garrus, or Rex, with me instead of Garrus, because Garrus kind of sucks. His abilities aren't that useful.
But equalizing interior
biotic
pressure,
abilities are freaking
atmosphere.
Overpowered in Mass Effect 1, so...
Logged. The commanding officer is ashore.
Hopefully I'll have better luck than I have been having with two biotics instead of just one.
Considering the diminished numbers of the Krogan, Rex, I'm surprised that you are willing to fight and kill them.
Anyone who fights us is either stupid or on Saren's payroll. Killing the latter is business. Killing the former is a favor to the universe.
Hello, Commander.
Show me what you got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
Oh, I can afford one of the Spectre weapons at least. Good. I can stop getting my ass kicked. Well, maybe I won't use Rex, because he does not have the biotic abilities that I like. Maybe I'll bring back Cade, and he's got biotic abilities.
Good to see you, Commander.
Reporter Kalisa Al-Jilani recently attempted to land an interview with Commander Shepard, the first human Spectre. Commander Shepard answered difficult questions, demonstrating that under that military uniform is a keen diplomatic mind. We'll have exclusive footage later today.
Your Novaria report raised a few eyebrows in the Council, Shepard. I can't believe you let that queen live. There's a reason their species was nearly wiped out. You should have finished them off.
You weren't there, Ambassador. It was my call. I did the right thing.
Really? I'm glad you're an expert in a species we know virtually nothing about. I hope we're both still around in 50 years to see if you're right.
Genocide of an entire species is a terrible tragedy, Ambassador. Shepard did the right thing.
Fine. I'll just tell everyone we figured it was a good idea to release a fertile Rachni queen in the wilds of Novaria. I'm sure nobody will have a problem with that.
And I wonder why nobody likes that guy.
Yes, Commander?
What do you know about Armistead Baines?
Where did you hear that name? Never mind, I don't want to know. Baines is dead. Has been for quite some time.
The people I spoke with seemed to think he was still alive.
It's not common knowledge. Military is keeping it under wraps. Baines was doing some high-level work for the Alliance. Stuff even I wasn't aware of. One day he turns up dead on a drifting scout ship. Everyone suspects it was foul play, but it was never officially investigated.
What can you tell me about the ship?
I don't know much about it. You should talk to Admiral Kohoku. One of his crews discovered Baines' body.
I spoke to Kohoku. He never brought it up.
You should mention Baines the next time you see him. See if he'll tell you anything. Is there anything else, Commander?
Do you know anything about Vermeer?
Sorry, Shepard. I've never even heard of it before all this. You'll have to go out there and check it out for yourself.
I should go.
I'll be
here. It's kind of concerning that one of the most experienced space officers that Earth has never heard of a major corporate hub in outer space. Oh, the Citadel. I hate wandering around here, seeing if there's anything new.
I'm telling you, this is not what Jake would want.
Who are you to tell me what my husband would want?
Here's one of the most random side quests in the game.
You're in danger.
I don't care what you think, Michael. It's my decision.
I know you're hurting, Rebecca, but don't let your grief hurt your baby, too.
Can I help with anything?
Perhaps you can talk some sense into her.
I don't need anyone to talk sense into me, Michael. I'm not undergoing the treatments.
My sister-in-law here is pregnant, and she's refused to let the baby undergo gene therapy in utero.
I thought gene therapy was common.
My husband Jacob died from a rare heart condition several months ago.
There's a chance that the baby could develop the same heart condition, but routine gene therapy can eliminate it.
A very small chance, Michael. And extranet reports say the therapy could
help. I heard on the internet.
It's less dangerous than the genetic enhancements that every soldier in the Alliance receives.
What are the chances that your child will develop the heart condition?
According to the doctors, there's a 1 in 50 chance. And if my baby develops the condition, medical treatments are available.
Which are nowhere near as effective as simply getting the gene therapy.
What are the chances that gene therapy could hurt the baby?
1 in 300 at most.
But extranet articles say there could still be long-term complications we don't know about. Don't you understand? If my baby is that 1 in 300, I will always wonder if I... If I killed my baby for nothing.
Oh. You know, I think she's crazy because she's basing this off something she read on the internet, but it's still her choice.
It's Rebecca's child, Michael. I think you should honor her decision.
Damn it, she's not choosing. She's acting blindly out of grief.
I know you want the best for your brother's child, but this is not your decision.
Of course it is! I'm the closest thing to a father this baby is going to have.
Is this about keeping the baby safe, or is this about you losing your last link to your brother?
This baby is the only thing my brother... It's all I have left of him. I need to know that the baby's safe.
It's all I have left too, Michael.
I just want Jacob's child to be safe. I want to give him that much.
We will. I promise. Thank you for talking with us. I appreciate it.
Can you just imagine if that had happened in real life, how bizarre that would be? It's like people having a loud discussion about life choices and then a stranger walks up to them and gives them advice. Just how inappropriate that would be. And now I'm cast as the hero for doing that very thing. This was so bizarre that even Mass Effect 2 comes back to mock it.
Spent your entire adult life just studying old Prothean junk?
Our travels now are somewhat different from my normal excavations. I would prefer lengthier studies and fewer explosions.
It's good for you. A nice explosion every now and then keeps the mind sharp.
Time, huh?
I'm sorry, do we know each other?
I guess you don't remember me. Lieutenant Zabaleta, I worked with your mother. We served on the carrier Einstein. Well, that was 12, 13 years back, though. You were just a kid then.
I guess you're not in the service anymore, huh?
You're retired, yeah. You know how it is. Times are tough for vets. They always are.
I didn't see her much that tour. The ship was on patrol most of the time.
Hey, call your mom up and ask. She'd remember old Zabaleta. She'd vouch for me. Look, I need a favor. I'm kind of short on money these days. I hate hitting you up for money, but a man's gotta eat, right? So, could you spare something? Maybe 20 credits.
20 isn't enough to get you back on your feet, is it?
No. I'll just get a meal, you know.
Yeah, it's not a problem.
You're a good kid, you know that? Thanks. You ever want to come by and talk, I'll be here. Huh? Can't afford a ticket home.
Yeah.
Right?
Only because 20 credits is nothing. I have thousands and thousands of credits. That's the special quest in Mass Effect that only Spacer Origin Shepherds can get.
A research station on Novaria has reportedly been destroyed. The exact cause is currently unknown. Given the research conducted on Novaria, many are blaming the destruction on an experiment gone awry. Administrator Anoleus currently faces criminal charges as a result of the disaster, although the nature of the charges remains unclear.
I like the Spacer Origin better than the other ones because it's the most ordinary. Like, pretty sure the Shepherd's father is dead, but the Shepherd's mother actually stays alive through the whole trilogy. And it's just kind of a ordinary relationship. There's no real angst there. There's no tragedy just forced upon it. It's nice. It's like the other origins are like, you're an orphan from the street who drug himself up from nothing to become one of the best soldiers in space. Like, yeah, whatever.
I got business here.
Go away.
Commander, I've been waiting for you to get back. I've got an idea, and I wanted to run it by you.
I got a lot going on right now, but I can spare a moment.
Great! This'll just take a minute. With so many human colonies being attacked, I'm not sure that one Spectre is enough. What if you signed me on as another Spectre?
Conrad, I haven't been shot in the head nearly enough times to make that seem like a good idea.
Joke if you want, but there were people who didn't believe in you, and you worked out, right? I want to be with you, fighting the good fight like you did on Elysium during the Skillian Blitz.
I believe you, Conrad, but there's another fight that needs you.
What? I don't understand.
You know what keeps me going out here? Knowing that people back home are keeping humanity strong.
You're right. I just got so caught up in all of it. I wanted to help. I'll go home. Thanks for setting me straight.
Yeah, he doesn't go home. We see him again. Well, he seems fine.
Yeah, what is it? Seems the owner didn't like the way you played their games.
Doran didn't have a clue what I was doing. He assumed I was cheating.
But you were cheating, were you not?
I was just tipping the scales in my favor, only as an experiment.
Still sounds like cheating to me.
To you, maybe. But this device is merely intended to simulate situations and record results. Recording losses is easy. Of course, nobody notices those.
Why do you need to record these outcomes?
Ah, now you're getting to the heart of it. I've spent the last 5 years developing a system that can accurately predict wins and losses on the Quasar. I just need a few more recorded wins and I can complete the algorithms.
Can you do that? Isn't that illegal?
It's illegal to use my system, but I won't.
Oh, okay.
I'll sell it to others. I just need a few more wins recorded.
Does the device help me win?
The device is set to emit a frequency that will slightly increase your odds. Nothing like my system eventually will, but enough to allow you to record your wins more quickly.
What's in this for me?
Keep your winnings. That should be payment enough, I think.
Does the device help me win?
Nothing like my system eventually will, but...
Why don't you just sell the device, then?
What? No. This device is archaic. It uses brute force to achieve its goal. Besides, you saw how easily it was detected. My system, when it's complete, will be far more efficient and completely undetectable.
I'll help you out.
I suppose I could let you try it. Here you go. When you've recorded enough wins, it'll let you know. Of course, if you get caught with the device, well, you saw what happened to me. Well, off you go. That data won't collect. That's not what I have.
Don't often see someone getting as lucky as you. Welcome to Flux. Name's Doran. What can I do for you?
Goodbye.
Enjoy your time here at Flux. Your luck seems
unnatural. No, that's fine.
Human.
See ya.
Five wins with the device yet?
Here you go. I hope it's what you're looking for.
Excellent indeed. This will provide me with invaluable data. You enjoy those winnings. I'm gonna get the system completed.
Yes, Commander. Is there something I can do for you?
I'll be going now.
Okay. Now let's head to the moon.
Your biotics are pretty powerful. Are all Asari that strong?
While the Asari have natural biotic abilities, not all have the desire to learn to use their abilities effectively.
All that power and some Asari don't use it? You could have conquered the galaxy if you'd wanted to.
Evidently, we do not want to.
Yeah. And then we find out in Mass Effect 3 they're keeping all the best toys to themselves.
Being in the city must feel good after digging through rocks at that Prothean ruin.
No, cities and stations were always my mother's area of comfort. I actually enjoy the solitude of dig sites.
I'm surprised. I've never met an Asari who didn't prefer clean clothes and a hot bath.
Do to do.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress. Decontamination in progress. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. XO Presley stands relieved.
Computer, give me a real-time connection to the dreadnought Kilimanjaro. I want to speak to my mother, XO Shepard.
Shepard speak? Oh, hi. I don't have time for a personal call right now. I'm on duty.
Forget it. I'm busy, too. Do you remember a Lieutenant Zabaleta from the Einstein?
Ernesto? Have you heard from him? He was one of the Marines who guarded the CIC. We shared a watch. I lost track of him after there was an incident.
I've seen him here on the Citadel. Looks like he's had some hard times.
I don't doubt it. You remember the Batarian raid on Mindwar in 2170? You were in high school. The Einstein's task group responded to the Mayday. The Batarians were still pulling out when the Marines hit groundside. Zabaleta was one of the first down. He was never quite the same after.
I don't understand. What happened down there?
About every abomination that a sentient being can do to another. To a slaver, a person is just another animal. And humans aren't always liked out here. We heard about corralling. Culling. They'd shoot those they couldn't use, implant control devices in the skulls of those they could, without anesthetic.
He has post-traumatic stress because of what he saw?
He tried to keep working, but it rode him. He showed up drunk their eyes. On duty more and more. We couldn't always cover for him. The Alliance discharged him. Everyone knew he drank because of what he'd seen down there, even if he never talked about it. Especially because he never talked about it.
For it to have affected him that deeply, he must have been a very sensitive man.
He was. Always in laughter and tears. If you see him, tell him we still worry about him. Tell him to go to the Veterans Affairs office. I have to go. But take care of yourself. You're making us proud. Kilimanjaro out.
All right, I'll deal with him next time I'm on the Citadel. I want to get out of here. I want to help a veteran, but I don't want to ride elevators anymore. Nothing. Yes, this is space travel in Mass Effect 1. Navigating menus. There we go. Caden's got the abilities I want. Thank you.
first.
Don't remember if there's any resources to find in the moon or not. I would think not, but yeah, hard to tell with this game. Now, you remember what Isaac Newton says in the second game? If you fire a weapon powered by Mass Effect technology, somewhere, some way, you are ruining somebody's day. So by firing these bullets at Earth, I'm killing people. That's okay, the game doesn't explore that. Come on. Time for one of the mass-produced side quest buildings where every single building looks exactly the same because every single building pretty much is exactly the same. They will recycle this building for several more quests in this game. Okay. See, it's still a stupid game, but at least now I can kill things because I have a better gun.
Lead on, Commander.
So, the VI is now releasing toxic gas into the bunkers, but it's definitely not an AI, even though it is clearly defending itself. Oh shoot, oh shoot, 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 shoot. Oh yeah, that'll stop me. Not a very smart AI. Although I guess I can't fault it for working with the limited tools it's given. Thank you. Rocket drones, that's not good. Oh, this is so not good. This nonsense. Oh, come on. I'm screwed. Thanks for not letting me save for whatever reason. And once again, Mass Effect proves that it's not a cover-based shooter in spite of presenting itself as one. Oh, jeez, I'm all the way back here. I'm kind of annoyed now. Do you see from what just happened there how useless cover is? Cover is only useful when enemies are willing to play along with the game and not just charge at you en masse like that. This is not a cover-based shooter, in spite of pretending to be one. Okay, back to the rocket drone spam. Hopefully I'll have better luck this time. And I really mean that. A lot of the time Mass Effect getting through a level comes down to luck. Hoping that the AI will behave like an idiot and allow you to kill it. How many of them are in there? Like five or six? All firing one-hit kill rockets? This game's ridiculous. Cover-based shooter. Thank you. is this nonsense? Sometimes there are games that are released where you get the impression that the people who made them didn't playtest them. I often get that feeling with Mass Effect. It's like, they just threw it together and said, does this sound like this should work? Yeah, it sounds like it should work. Should we test it to make sure it does work? Nah, I got a tea time. And yet I've beaten this game several times on this difficulty level, so I shouldn't complain as much as I am. I know it's perfectly doable. It's just a unholy pain in the ass. One rocket to the base out. Did you see that? Why am I not firing? Oh, come on. Oh. Why blocked? Why are we blocked? Let me do things. Hmm. Mass Effect 1 is a bad game. It's bad. Which is to say, it's not good. It's poorly designed. With their rocket spam. What am I supposed to do? Taking cover does not help, Caden. Taking cover gets you killed. What are you shooting at, Liara? Let me control my own ally, thank you. This is a bad game. I was really into Mass Effect 2 when just before it came out, and it was all because of this game, and I'm trying to understand what I was thinking. Where I thought that I really want to play the sequel to this. It's a good thing I did, because Mass Effect 2 is an amazing game. Mass Effect 1 is not. Mass Effect 1 is awful. This is a bad game. Thank you. What was I thinking? Why did I used to think this game was amazing? This is awful. They deal too much freaking damage, and they take too much punishment, and... oh my god. There's the good kind of hard, and there's the stupid kind of hard. This is the stupid kind of hard. Fine. I don't have to go into cover behind the stupid force field. What guns are you using? Why is Liara using a shotgun? They're not trained, but whatever. Use those guns, not your random thing you decided to use, because you're idiots. Although I think we did much better that time. Okay, I'll just direct my idiotic companions not to use completely random guns, and we'll do much better. Well, Liara's supposed to know Overload. Why doesn't she? She has the ability. That's weird. Guess I shouldn't be surprised, given how poorly made this game is, but yeah. Back up, back up, back up. Stop running around in front of me. Freaking idiot. Game is bad, it's a bad game, it's not well made, it's very poorly designed. It's a cover-based shooter where cover is completely worthless. Or, it's a third-person shooter that has a cover system in it for no reason. You know, take your pick. Back. Stop standing out in the open. Why is he blocked? Caden, be available. Oh, and the tunnel is still filled with these little jerks. Yay, I'm dead. I don't know what else to do. I'm desperate now. So I'm changing to a gun that I'm not having any upgrades for. Oh, forget that. I can't aim down the sight. Oh, this game is awful. Bad game is bad. Use barrier. Them. This game is very confused about Liara because she's able to equip an Omni-Tool. She's pure biotic. Why is she equipping an Omni-Tool? Why are there so many of them? Oh, and there's another. How long have I been doing this? An hour? I smell bad game. Oh, great. More security drones. Yay. Because there's not already 15 of them in there, or however many. Thank you. excited out there that Liara is still alive, but it seems to be working, so I'm going to ignore it. Just be glad that I found out the solution to beating those things is to just ignore them and run past them. That was stupid. But hey, I got through it. Even if it turned out that the way to get through it was to completely ignore everything trying to kill me. Who would have thought? I have no idea what to upgrade. Thank you. the hell are those? Okay. Okay, if there were any extra resources on this planet, I would have found them by now, so moving on. Game design. Okay, and now begins the long, tedious process of exploring every planet in the galaxy. I tried this last time I was playing the game, and I wasn't quite a high enough level. I think I'm a higher level now, I think I can handle it now. Did not increase my excitement for it at all. Let's go, Mako. Yeah, there are two camps on the Mako. Some people really love it. Everybody else hates it. I'm in the hate group. There's a good reason that the Mako does not show up in Mass Effect 2 and 3. It's because the Mako is awful. Last time I was here, I was not able to do that because I didn't have a high enough decryption skill. Another probe I had to ignore first time I found it because I didn't have high enough skill to access it. But not anymore. See if everybody is still dead up here from the last time I was here. And they are good. Last time I was here, I got inside the building, but wasn't quite powerful enough to take the things inside, so I just left. I couldn't take it anymore. And if I can't take them now, then I'm in trouble. Hey, you want to do that? No, she's dead. Being dead is the only time I'll tolerate you not doing what I tell you.
I owe you one.
Look at everybody running around in circles. You see what a farce it is that this is a cover-based shooter? This is not a cover-based shooter. This is Doom in third person. And remember this building layout, because we'll be seeing it quite a few times more as we explore the rest of the planets. They really love to recycle building layouts in this game. Because, you know, design a unique area for every area in the game? That takes work! Luckily in Mass Effect 2 and 3, they actually did go to the trouble to design a unique area for every quest in the game, instead of just recycling content and procedurally generating planets to explore. Thank you. I guess I already did what was there. I think that's where you pick up Liara, which I already did quite some time ago. So moving on. No. No, that's where you pick up Liara. Huh. Well, guess there's just nothing there. Hey. One last procedurally generated planet to explore, that's fine with me. Okay. Exploring the galaxy in Mass Effect 1 is very tedious. It's not fun. I don't know a single person who actually compliments this aspect of the game, but doing it does make life a lot easier in Mass Effect 2, so I'm putting up with it. One more time, but I really think this is going to be the last time that I suffer through Mass Effect. Oh, screw this game. It is not good. Every time I replay it, my opinion of it lowers even more. I just gotta make sure that I'm actually bringing Rex and Garrus with me when I do those missions. Otherwise, they get mad at me, and I don't want that. my tank that can't aim. There we go.
Everybody.
According to these data logs, the survey team unearthed some kind of alien technology.
Guess we should head to the excavation site then.
I'm sure they're fine. They're not fine.
Thank you.
And here you'll see another example of why calling Mass Effect a cover-based shooter is a farce. Bright side, unlike those freaking rocket drones, my abilities actually do something against the husks, which is nice.
Mindless fanatics.
Whatever they found, it's long gone now.
Oh, Mass Effect can actually be kind of satisfying when it functions the way it's supposed to. Instead of just mobbing you with dozens of rocket drones at once, who your crowd control abilities do not work against. I'm playing as an infiltrator on this run, and infiltrators kind of suck, which is part of the reason I'm having so much difficulty. I'm sure plenty of people watching this will probably go, why isn't he playing as like a biotic or something so he can use the good abilities? Well, that's because in Mass Effect 2 and 3, they actually make the non-biotic classes worth playing as, so I'm suffering through this as an infiltrator. So I can have more fun in Mass Effect 2. Where being an infiltrator actually means something instead of being just a weak engineer. Alright, now I just gotta wander around a bit, see if I can find that last mineral on the planet. I think there are three on every planet, but I could be wrong about it. Oh boy. Yeah, I wanna get out of here. I don't fight Thresher Maws. They are not fun to deal with. Just, it really highlights just how awful the Mako is, that Thresher Maws are deadly in this game, in the Mako, and yet in Mass Effect 2 you fight one on foot and you manage to take it down. I mean, just from a narrative standpoint, that shows you how awful the Mako is. Maybe there isn't. Maybe there is only two on this planet. Which is why the finding the rare minerals side quest is a particular pain in the butt, because it doesn't tell you, that I know of, when you've found everything on the planet. You just have to wander around and hope that you do. Luckily, they always appear kind of in little valleys and clusters in the mountain ranges, so I know there's not going to be one in that big expanse of nothing there. If you see something big and flat, there ain't going to be any minerals hidden there, so you don't need to look. Alright, forget this planet. I've complained in the past about games that, you know, just dot things around the landscape and then give you a waypoint and says, go get them! And then I complain about this for dotting things in the landscape and not giving me a waypoint. It's a fair argument to make that I'm being hypocritical there, but I would argue that I want it in a landscape without a waypoint, but I want that landscape to be fun to explore. As I have established at length in the past, the Mako is not fun. It is boring, it is badly designed, it is not fun to drive, it is certainly not fun to fight in. So that is my argument for that. It sounds kind of like No Man's Sky is kind of going for the same kind of thing, but I'm hoping that they do it better. You know, we can only hope. I'll be disappointed if No Man's Sky turns out to be a dud. Oh, Jesus. Hey, Rocket, why don't you fire where I'm aiming at, huh? Thank you. How far did I launch that guy, and he's not dead? Do you know how gravity works? The impact alone will kill you. I guess maybe this could be a low gravity planet, but the Mako is not demonstrating that. Hey, that's another thing. I never realized that before. Apparently we're going to different planets all throughout the galaxy. The Mako handles exactly the same on every single one. Shouldn't they all have different levels of gravity? Alright, let's go into this Syndicate hideout. I have no idea what the Syndicate is. And yes, this is the exact same layout as that last planet I was on that was full of husks, except this one is full of, yeah, mercenaries. Other than the layout of the boxes in the room, this is the exact same location. Yeah, just gonna pop out in front of me there. That's a good idea. Want to do it? Thank you.
Hold the line. Go, go, go.
A crime boss, eh? What the hell is this, eh? Space Mafia or something?
Go, go, go!
That guy was tough. I remember her now. Yeah, Space Mafia is pretty much right. Okay, if you're gonna just lock up this door, why don't you just lock up this door? That way I don't have to go into a tunnel that has absolutely nothing in it. You know, just game design 101. If there's nothing in it, it shouldn't be there. I didn't know there was an item limit, damn it. Oh. Thanks for directing me to this thing on that does nothing. That's real helpful. Kind of defeats the purpose of a waypoint on the map. It doesn't do anything. think what it was when I was really, really enthusiastic about Mass Effect, especially Mass Effect 1, was when I had just done the main story. Because I think, like, certainly the first time, and maybe even the first two or three times I beat this game, I just played the main story. I didn't do all this side crap. It's when I started doing all the side content, like exploring the galaxies and doing all the little collection side quests, that I just really, really, really started to hate this game. I mean, I'm not at hate now. I've come to terms with my feelings about it, so I don't hate it, but it's not fun. I'm not enjoying it, and I don't think it's a good game. And the only reason I'm suffering through it right now is because I really want to do a complete replay of the entire Mass Effect trilogy, including Mass Effect 1. I think this will be the last time that I ever play this game, unless I go insane or feel that I need to study the game again. But I really don't think that's going to happen. This is not fun. This is not good. Come on, can we just go? Stupid Mako. I got everything on that planet. Alright, gotta clear up my inventory now, because apparently it's getting full. I forgot that could happen. Maybe that wouldn't happen if this game didn't shower you with so much worthless crap, but it does. I mean, like, at least, you know, an RPG like Diablo, that showers you with worthless crap too. But you can choose not to pick up most of the worthless crap. Mass Effect forces you to pick up everything, so it forces you to sort through it all and decide what's good and what isn't. Whereas in Diablo, I can just look at something and see, oh, that's not a unique weapon.
Looking
I don't
for
need
supplies?
To pick it up.
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander.
See how long this takes. Sell, 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 sell. I will definitely be able to afford more Spectre gear after this, though. There we go. Thank you. Okay. I guess now I don't need to be saving my money. I have the two Spectre weapons I
wanted
to get.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what
you got.
Get
better armor.
You bet, Commander.
Crap. No, of course you don't. Okay, goodbye. .99999999999% of the gear in this game is completely worthless. Very little is an upgrade. It has happened to me more than once where I've played through this game and not actually ever found a piece of armor that is an upgrade to what you begin the game with. That's happened to me more than once. I'm going to call it here for the night. I will resume tomorrow, hopefully for a good chunk of the day, so I'll clear out a pretty good chunk of Mass Effect so I can get this turd over with and start on Mass Effect 2.